Very good morning, my dearest children. How are you doing? I hope you all are doing well. So welcome back in your English class. As we did yesterday, forms of verb. Okay, there are three forms of verb. That is present, past, and past participle. Okay. So today we are going to start another topic, that is tense, and this is also related with the forms of verb only. So don't worry. See what a tense means. Tense means forms of verb only. So any of the forms of a verb which distinguish when an action or state of being occurs or exists means verb forms tells us about the time of an action, whether it happened in the past or it happens in the present or it will happen in the future. So when we use them, we use these verb forms according to the tense. Okay, so there are in English, my dear students, see here, actually there are three tenses. Okay, so present, past, and future. F-U-T-U-R-E, future. Don't say future, it is future. Okay, present, past, and future. So after that, don't worry, we'll discuss about one only, but just let me tell you beta that what are tenses and how many types of tenses are there. So that's why I'm just telling you. So just an introduction. Okay, so present, past, and future, there are three tenses, and afterwards each tense is divided into four parts. Okay, that is four parts. It has also four parts, and it has also four parts. Okay, so how many tenses are there? Three: present, past, and future. And after present, past, and future, each tense is having four parts. Okay, so what is present, what is past, and what is future? Question is there. So present means what is related with us today. I'm here, I explain the chapter. The sun rises in the east, we go to school, my mother cooks food. That all is present tense, because your mother is doing that thing. Today we are doing this thing, so that is present. Okay, I explained about the verb forms means yesterday. Okay, we took dinner means yesterday we took dinner. Okay, we went to the market means yesterday we went to the market. So that is past means what had happened earlier. जो हमने पहले कर लिया, जो काम हमने पहले कर लिया, that is our past. You were in grade 1, आप first में थे, that is also your past. Now you are in grade 2, this is your present. And you will be in grade 3, that is your future. Okay, we will go to the market, we will eat pizza there. So that is also future tense. Okay, so three tenses. Present means that happens every day, that is related with our present, that is related with our today. Okay, and past, that happened, and future, that will happen. Okay, so again, my dear children, I'm talking about present tense. Okay, don't worry, I'm not going to tell you about the four types of tense. No, you are sweet, cutest children. So we do only one type, okay? And present tense. First of all, present tense means that is related with our present. Okay. And we will do here simple present tense. That is simple present tense. So what is simple present tense, beta? Simple present tense means that happens every day. That is a part of our daily routine. For example, I take bath, I go to school, my mother cooks food, my father goes to office. See, I play cricket, I play cricket So these are the examples of simple present that you are doing in your that daily routine. Okay, your habitual that any habitual action is there. For example, the earth revolves around the sun. The sun rises in the east. That is also simple present tense. Okay. Now we should know that how we have to use, because when we have actually in tenses, what we do, beta, we are changing the verb only. Only verb form we have to change. Either we will use first form or second or maybe third. Okay, so like that we are using. It means we are not going to change the subject or object or pronoun. So very simple means we have to be careful while we have to use verb forms. Okay, so here see children. For example, from your you can see that my uncle blank. Okay, me a watch. Okay, it can be past also, but see, there is not any. Actually, I am telling you that you have to fill this blank with simple present tense. Okay, so see here, my uncle dash me a watch. So what's here? My uncle in the bracket he give is given. Okay, so my uncle. See again, beta, there are three persons: first person, second person, and third person. So my uncle, third person is the person about whom you are talking. First person is the speaker. For example, if I am saying something, I am first person. Okay, second person is only one, and that is you. Means second person to whom you are talking, who is listening to you. Okay, that is the second person, and third person means about whom you are talking. Means my uncle is the third person here. So with the third person and singular, and my uncle, we have done singular plurals, beta. So what is this singular? So with uncle is singular, so I will write here, my uncle gives me a watch. Okay, then she blank with me. So in the blank there is given play. So what you will write here, she again, see this, which person is this she, beta? This she is third person, because we are talking about any other person, and first person I and we, and second person who is listening to me, you. It means any other person, we both are talking. If I am saying to you that she blank with me, so I am first person, you are listening to me, you are second person, so she is third person, and she is only one term, so it means singular. So here I will write play, and s. She plays means along with the first form we have to add s or es. Okay, so she plays with me. One more example, beta, see, we dash TV every Sunday. Okay, so here it is given watch. Now you see, we blank TV every Sunday. So what we will write here, see this we, which person is this? Third person. No, not at all. This we is first person, because I am also including in that. We means I am saying this thing, that we. So this is first person. I and we are first person only. So first person, so with first person we use only first form, that is watch. Don't add s or es. We watch TV every Sunday. That is the structure. Like this we have to use sentences, and there are many sentences in simple present tense. For example, you have to say that write about your mother. So your mother, if you are writing about your mother, she is a third person. Okay, because mother means any other name of any person, or that is third person only. So my mother lives in Sikar, my mother cooks yummy food. It means we have to add s there. Actually, these are grammatical mistakes if we are not adding s or es to the verb when we are making any sentence in simple present tense. So we should concentrate on these things. Okay, so you are the youngest students, so it means you can avoid these mistakes if you will start doing practice better. So my mother plays with me my mother washes my clothes. Don't say that my mother wash my clothes. No, my mother washes my clothes. Okay, my mother helps me to complete my work. My mother respects everyone. Okay, so like this we can say. You have to make sentence. Sentences in simple present. Now, if you are talking about and remember, you have to use only and only first form of verb. So I think you are getting my point, Beta. To make sentences, you should know the verb forms. You should have the knowledge of verb forms. So please just try to learn all the verb forms whatever I have provided to you. So if you have to write a topic, write on the topic that about yourself. For example, you have to say that my name is this and this. I live in Sikar. So you will not say I lives in Sikar. No. I, because you are a first person when you are saying that I. Mother was the second person, then we said that mother lives in Sikar. You will say I live in Sikar. I like to play football. I like fruits. I respect everyone. I complete my work on time. So like this you have to make the sentences. These are about simple present tense. Okay, so I hope you understood, and if you have any queries you can ask me anytime. Most welcome, Beta. So that's all for today. Thank you, children. Bye bye. Be safe and be happy.